Hello, my name is Liam Gaffney and I'm a research fellow in nuclear physics at the University of Liverpool. I study the structure of radioactive isotopes by measuring the radiation emitted during nuclear reactions. Radiation is all around us, but what is it and where does it come from? We encounter three common types of ionizing radiation in our daily lives. They are alpha radiation. This is the emission of a heavy particle made of two protons and two neutrons from the nucleus of a radioactive isotope. The second one is beta radiation. Beta particles are just electrons, but they are spat out from the nucleus of an atom as a proton changes to a neutron, or vice versa. And finally, gamma rays and X-rays, which often come along with beta and alpha particles as the atom and the nucleus rearrange themselves and lose excess energy after the decay. Gamma rays and X-rays are just photons, the same as visible light or radio waves, but much, much higher in energy. In large quantities, ionizing radiation has the potential to be hazardous to living things, since it damages cells by knocking electrons from atoms and molecules as it collides with them. That's why we try to shield ourselves from strong sources of radiation. Shielding of the heavy, very ionizing alpha particles is quite easy, since they can be stopped with a piece of paper or the dead layers of your skin. This means that they don't cause harm unless they enter your body. The lighter beta particles pass through the paper without interacting too much, but can be stopped in a couple of millimeters of aluminium. Intense amounts of beta radiation can cause burns, as they are mostly absorbed in the skin. Gamma rays and X-rays pass through quite a lot of material before interacting, which makes them difficult to shield. If we want to quantify the amount of radiation around us, we can count the number of these particles using a device such as a Geiger counter. Every click you hear is from a particle entering the detector and ionizing a small volume of gas inside, creating a little bit of charge, which is then detected. But the different types of radiation have different effects on the human body. So we measure the amount of radiation we receive as a dose, which accounts for the type and location of the radiation within the body. The unit we use to measure that is the sievert, which is roughly the energy absorbed per kilogram of body tissue. If you work in a radiation environment like I do, this dose is usually monitored with a dosimeter. These devices can be made of a photographic film that is checked every couple of months for the level of activation, indicating the dose received by the person wearing it. A handy reference for this dose measurement comes from the humble banana, which is high in potassium and really good for you. But one in every 10,000 potassium atoms is the naturally occurring radioactive isotope potassium-40. So every time you eat a banana, you receive a dose of radiation equivalent to 0.1 microsieverts. Fortunately, that's a really small dose. Ionizing radiation is also present in the environment in the form of radon gas, which we breathe in, and carbon-14 and potassium-40, which are in the ground and in plants and animals around us. These sources combine to give us the vast majority of our radiation dose, about 6 microsieverts per day, or equivalent to eating 60 bananas. Now, I said common types earlier because we also receive a small amount of ionizing radiation from outer space in the form of charged particles from the sun or from cosmic rays from across the universe. Our Earth's magnetic field does a really good job of protecting us from this, but the higher up you go, on top of a mountain, in an aeroplane, or even on the International Space Station, the more and more dose you will receive. On the ground, this corresponds to about 1 microsievert per day, or 10 bananas. If you take a flight to New York, you'll get about 10 days worth of radiation, or 100 bananas. But where does this common or terrestrial radiation come from? There are a number of sources all around us, both natural and as a result of human activity. You're familiar with X-ray images for diagnosing broken bones or wobbly teeth. This is a form of radiation, but the dose from an X-ray is only 5 microsieverts, or 50 bananas, less than the dose we receive from all natural background sources throughout the course of a single day. A CT scan is basically hundreds of X-ray images, so your dose is a few hundreds of times larger, and doctors are usually very careful when deciding if this additional risk is necessary. In my research, we produce radioactive isotopes to study them in nuclear reactions, but in much smaller quantities than you get from nuclear power plants. Nuclear reactors produce energy through the fission of uranium, which creates radioactive waste products. In all of these, the radiation is well contained, but there have been a few infamous nuclear accidents that release radioactivity into the environment. Close to home, in 1957, a fire at the Windscale reactor in Cumbria released a large amount of cesium-137. Thanks to its 30-year half-life, about a quarter of the original cesium-137 activity can still be observed today in sand samples taken from beaches near here in Liverpool. If you dig down deep enough, you can find a spike in radiation levels from that accident more than 60 years ago. But this Geiger counter isn't sensitive enough to detect that above background levels. In 1986, a reactor meltdown at Ukraine's Chernobyl nuclear power plant released around 4,000 times more cesium-137 than the Windscale fire. As a result, a small sample of sand taken from a village near the accident has a much higher radioactivity today than the beaches of Liverpool. Nowadays though, Chernobyl contributes just 1/20th of a banana to our daily radiation dose in the UK. Not even a bite.